Listen to the story, The Turning Point by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. I remember my teacher, Sri Shiva Subramanya Iyer, who taught me in class 5. It was he who sowed the seeds of a vision in my life. He was a very good teacher and all of us loved to attend his class. One day, he was teaching us about a bird's flight. He drew a diagram of a bird in flight and explained how it creates lift. He also explained how it changes direction while flying. For 25 minutes, he lectured us on things such as lift, drag, and how birds fly in formations of 10, 20, or 30. At the end of the class, he wanted to know whether we had understood how a bird flies. I said I had not understood. When I said this, he asked whether the others had understood or not. Many students said that they too had not understood. Our teacher was really concerned about this, but he did not get upset by our response. He wanted us to understand the principles of flight. So he said that he would take all of us to the seashore. That evening, the whole class was on the beach. He drew our attention to the seagulls flying in formation. There were about 20 of them. It was a marvelous formation of birds with a purpose, and we were all amazed as we began to recall what we had heard that morning. The teacher then asked us to look at the birds' wings, how they flapped to generate lift. He asked us to look at the tail and the combination of flapping wings and twisting tail. We looked closely and found that the birds in that position could fly in the direction they wanted to. Then he asked us a question. Can you tell me where the bird's engine is and how it is powered? We knew the answer to that question. All the aspects of the principles of flight became clear to us within the next 15 minutes. We understood clearly the dynamics of a bird's flight with the practical example of it in front of our eyes. Our teacher was the greatest. He had given us a lesson in theory as well as in practice. This is real teaching and learning, I thought to myself. For me, this incident was not merely an understanding of how a bird flies. That evening on the seashore of Rameshwaram, I decided that I wanted to study all I could about the concept of flight. At that time, I did not realize that eventually I would move towards the study of the science of flying. It was my teacher's lesson and the flight I had witnessed which inspired me to move towards this goal. Then, one evening after class, I asked Mr. Iyer for advice. I told him of my interest in further studying the science of flight. He patiently explained that I should complete class 8, go to high school, and from there to college and take up the study of the sciences. This advice and the lesson of the flight of birds really gave me my mission for life. So when I went to college, I took up physics and then went on to study engineering at the Madras Institute of Technology. There I took up aeronautical engineering. My life was transformed. I became a rocket engineer, an aerospace engineer, and a technologist. This memory of my teacher encouraging me to ask questions and then showing real-life examples to aid my comprehension remained with me all my life. After all, it had proved a turning point in my life. It initiated and eventually shaped my profession. Sri Shiva Subramanya Iyer was the catalyst who ignited our young minds by allowing us to ask questions and then answering them till we achieved complete understanding.